What's up, Men 17 fans? My name is Cody, and I want to welcome you to today's video. Today's video is going to be the first installment of a little bit of a newer series to my channel, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope that it's a lot of use to you guys. I really do, because what I get questions all the time is like, what plays do you use, or how can I create a better scheme, or like that seems to be what the questions are. So what I want to do is a new series where I go through every playbook and I give you an hour or so of footage where I basically teach you what I would do, how I look for plays, those kind of things. And it's going to be just a random playbook. It's not going to be Pittsburgh Steelers, which is something that I know very well. It's going to be different types of playbooks. So we're just going to go into practice mode. I'm going to show you everything you need to know. So you go into practice mode. I recommend have two controllers. On defense, you want to load up a good solid, you want to find a defense that has good coverage, okay? The Raiders is actually a very good defense to lab with because of all the speed and different things that they bring to the table. Falcons are good. I mean, you just want to kind of find a good defense. I'm going to use the Patriots because their corners are really good for zone, and I know that zone is really popular. The defensive playbook that I would recommend labbing with is the Cincinnati Bengals, and that's because I think it has the most common formations from nickel to 4-3 to those kind of things. If you don't want to do that, what you could also do though is you could use the Cover 2 playbook, and it should have some of the similar things. Offensive playbook, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to pick just a playbook that I'm going to maybe practice with a little bit later. And that's going to be the Pittsburgh Steelers playbook, which if you guys haven't used that playbook, that's the playbook I normally use on the offensive side of the ball. So we'll just load up with that. On offense, it doesn't really matter what team you use. I personally like to use the Cowboys just because they're my favorite team. So we're going to go through and we're going to use them for all these videos probably, just because I love the Cowboys. So, and you've got to get their uniforms right. I mean, that's a given. So what I like is the white uniforms. While I'm doing this, if you have any questions about what we're doing or any questions about Madden in general, I encourage you to get in the comment section and ask the questions, okay? We're gonna start today with Arizona. So you just go to your playbook, you pick whatever playbook you wanna lab with. Today, we're gonna utilize Arizona, and then on defense, I'm gonna put a playbook that I might wanna look into a little bit more, and that's the Chiefs playbook, okay? So then you just ready up and you're ready to go. So the reason I did that was just kinda show you the process of how you really can lab new schemes and do things like that. So what am I going to look for when I get into practice mode? Well, I'm going to do a couple things. Number one, I'm going to practice against a defense I'm likely to see. So for me, that's nickel normal or $3-2-6. Okay, those are the two most popular defenses that I'm going to see, and I'm going to run coverages. So I'm going to see, number one, does it beat Tampa 2? Because that is the most popular defense in Madden. Number two, does it beat man-to-man coverage? Number three, does it beat the blitz? Those are kind of the three metrics that I want every play that I look at, I want to see if it can do that, okay? So defensively, it's pretty simple. We're going to go to nickel normal, and we're in the Cover 2 book. We're going to pick Cover 2 sync because that's the most popular defense. Now, what I like to do, first and foremost, when I'm looking at a brand new playbook, is I want to get a quick summary of everything it has to offer. So this one has single back jumbo. As you can see, there's several good plays here. You have the counter. Does it have a power O? Like, power O's are very effective to me. Zone weaks are okay, but I don't really like zone runs. So those are things that you need to kind of go through, a checklist of things you're looking for. Y stick, that looks like an interesting play. Counter weak looks pretty good. So this might be a unique formation that I might really want to look at, okay? So the counter, the stretch, you have the dive. Unfortunately, they don't have power O, though. Single back ace, they've got skinny post, HB stretch, PA stretch, PA zone a corner. Those are all really good plays. This is the Arizona playbook, too. Halfback counter, Z spot. So, you know, that's what I'm kind of looking for. does it have, what does it have to offer? Does it have any interesting things? So close PA, cross. It's got a really deep post route. Okay. Kind of look through here. Okay. Single back pair tight twins. Looks like it's got a really interesting thing. It's got a post route. When I find a route, like a post route, I want to see if it has a counter too. That's probably the biggest thing I can give you. So, like, for example, on this play, it has PA dig. So now, and you see that the far left receiver is running a post route. Now what I want to see is, does it have a play where the far left receiver is running a corner route or some type of out-breaking pattern? So here it does, four verticals. So there you go. So now I see that it has a power and a counter play. So that's so important. This underplay, I already know that's very good because of years past. This route to the running back is very effective. It's also got a draw in there, which is interesting. Okay, ace pair twins. It's got a post route. Now the question is, does it have a C route or something like that where it breaks to the outside? It doesn't. So in my opinion, this formation is gone. I don't want anything to do with it. That's how I kind of go through the list. Is I look at the pivotal routes that you have. So like here we have Z spot. We also have FL drive to counter it, but the FL drive, I know from experience, it takes a little bit to develop. So that's going to be something to kind of, that's going to be a tension to manage. Okay. Go through a tight flex week. Now this formation is interesting because it does a lot of cool things. I've seen it's been around for years in Madden. So again, this is something else you want to look at. So bench, as you see, it's in breaking route to the right side now, but it also has a C route. You see flank or spot. So this could be a really good little formation where we have a nice power counterbalance. It's got a zone weak. It's got a draw in there. So we might look into this a little bit more. In my opinion, though, the post route's not deep enough. Doubles. There we have a nice route, zona under. Really, really good play. Let's see what else we've got. We've got, now the question is, do we have an outbreaking pattern? We have a post route, good. Do we have an outbreaking pattern? Levels, one of my favorite plays in the game, just because of the way it works. So we don't have an outbreaking pattern. So to me, that's a big deal. Okay, we don't have a C route. We don't have something like that where it breaks to the outside. That's a big deal. Wide trips. This is a really good formation as well. As you can see, slot spot. Now we have an outbreaking pattern. Now do we have a post route off of that? Do we have kind of like a Z spot kind of feel to it? And as you see here, PA slot cross. So we have that. So this is a formation that's kind of still in the bucket. Okay. Let's see, we'll go to wing trips and we'll take a look at it. And we'll just kind of go through. Again, we just do this over and over again. Looking here, we got some cool things. We've got motioning, auto motion plays, which are interesting. Might have to look into that a little bit more. But the problem is, again, there's no outbreaking pattern. So all you have is a post route. Now you can make like outbreaking patterns like comebacks and things like that. But to me, it's so important. Now I want to look at the iForm Pro. I think the iForm Pro is very underrated. I think every formation matters. Like, you can do so much, man. Like, there's so much you can do. So X post. So there's a post route. Do I have a C route off that or some type of outbreak? I do. PA zone a slide. So that's a big deal. Okay, so this now makes this formation a viable option for me to at least look at. iPro twins, as you can see. Pretty good. Also, when you're looking at I formations, and really when you're looking at under center formations, I would recommend trying to figure out, can you have a three-headed rushing attack? And what I mean by a three-headed rushing attack is, can you have a run to the left, can you have a run to the right, and can you have a run directly down the middle? So for the pro twins, the counter is our run to the left, the ISO is our run to the middle, and then the halfback toss or the halfback stretch would be our run to the right, but they don't have the power O. And in my opinion, the power O is one of the better runs in the game. They have the tight pair. So here I'm looking again, power O, they have counter weak, they have ISO. So this is a really good formation because they have three ways to run the ball. They have PA spot and they have PA power O. Unfortunately, they don't have a C route or something to the left side. So that's a big deal as well. Something to kind of look at. And those are, again, those are all qualifying factors that you want to look at. Strong pro. We have the lead draw. We have the toss crack, we have the stretch, we have the counter, so we have everything we need. Z spot, which is a really, really good passing play from the strong pro because you have the post route. Now the question is, do we have a C route to complement it? We have a comeback route, but we don't have a C route However, in this play we do, so that's interesting. You have a quick deep out route. This mount motion Y flat. So there's something here. I think the strong pro is going to be where we're going to want to focus our running on, but they don't have a power out, so that's a big deal to me. However, we can probably get around them not having a power out. So that's kind of how I settled in. Pro Twins, you got the dive. Give me a power O, please. They got a bubble screen, which is unique. They've got the toss, the stretch. They don't have a power O, so that's kind of frustrating. I don't think any of the major running sets have a power O. Yeah, sometimes that happens in certain playbooks. Weak flex twins, very unique formation. Do we have a C route? Do we have something that breaks? It's not that C route necessarily I'm looking for. I'm looking for something that breaks to the outside that's not a streak or a deep, or not something that I can create with a hot route, okay? Weak tight paired. This looks very interesting to me. So we've got the post. Nice play. We've got the post. We've got another post. No power O. So that's kind of, yeah. That's not really something I want to look into. Twin Titan Flex Pistol. They got strong power. That's really good. I like strong powers this year. They've got motioning. I don't like auto motion runs very much because they're not very flexible. They've got those nice deep post routes, but they don't have anything that breaks to the outside. So again, that's kind of probably out. Split close. This is a very good split close. I know that from experience. So let's see. They've got a nice combination of routes here. They've got fullback inside, so that's good. They've got the slip screen. They've got wide receiver corner. So wide receiver corner and doubles ends, as you can see, those are very similar plays. The only difference is the route to the routes break to the outside instead of the inside, so that's good. They have halfback wheel. We all know how effective that is. They have fullback trail. We all know how effective that is. They don't have a corner route to the left guy, so that's kind of a miss in my opinion. You need that corner route there to kind of make them honor that. Ace twins, you have inside zone. Good. X spot, got a corner route. You got the post play. Okay, that's pretty good. Give me some kind of, they don't have a C route, they don't have anything that breaks to the outside though, to that far left receiver. You see how that can really, I think that can really affect your deal. So gun doubles. So we've got a post route, good. We have something off of our post route. We have a C route or something. And it's, as you can see, we don't. So I'm kind of probably going to be out on gun doubles because of that right there. Y trips. We have stick. We have clear out, which is a really good play. It's a really good levels concept. I really like that play. Now the question is, do we have something off of that? We have corner strike, which is pretty good. We have Y corner, which is pretty good. Do we have a post route to the left side of the field? We do have a post route, but they don't really go well together. So that's probably out on that as well. Gun wing trio weak. We've got a lot of motion plays here. I've seen this PA motion shot play do really well. Because I know people have ran that against me and it seems to work really well. Double post, that's good. Corner strike, 56 trap is a good run. But it doesn't really go together very well. You see, that's kind of the... That's the big deal. Do they go together really well? Okay, gun tray, you've got levels. Nice. Now, do you have an outbreaking pattern to the left side? Not really. Fake screen. You can do something with it. My opinion, there's not enough there, though. Bunch strong. We've got zone of flood. We've got Z-spot, one of my favorite plays in the game. Okay, we've got zone of drive. Which is a nice counter. We don't have that. They don't have that outbreaking pattern though. I mean, you can get away with zone of drive if you really. We may come back to this just because I know, and they have the inside zone, which is a really good running play. We might come back to this. Gun snugs. This is probably a very good passing formation. You've got zone of seams. PA zone across. You've got zone of corners with a spot route. Nice. You've got bench. Zone of Z spot. zona post. We'll probably start here with our passing. Okay, go ahead and flip trips. See, we have a post route to the left side. Deep fork. So there we go. There's something. So we have FL drive and deep fork. And wide receiver cross looks pretty good. So this actually, this will probably be where we start, because this is the only formation that has a very strong outbreaking pattern to the left side, or to the opposite side of the field. Actually, we might start here. So now they're kind of coming together for us. So gun spread, zone of corner. That's a good play because you've got the table route, you've got C route, you've also got a post route that's pretty good. Zone of shallow, that looks really good. Looks like a really good play there. You've got quick slot out. You've got zone of, there's all kinds of things you got here, man. And you've got zone of flood, which is a post route to the left side. You got four verticals, curl flats. I think you could do something with this spread. Okay, gun wide trips. There's PA wide receiver in. The question is, do we have an outbreaking route? Clear out, no. Nope, 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 we don't have anything. So that's out, to me. Gun empty bunch. This is a very unique formation. Do we have, we got a nice corner route, got drag. Well, we've got something here too. Let's see here. Empty tray flex. You have post route, wide corner. Nice. I mean, there's a lot here. Five wide, pretty nice too. All right, so that's kind of got through the whole playbook. Assuming their goal line is the same as everybody, and it is. So now what we want to do is we want to start developing things. So we remember the single back, ace pair, tight twins was important. So we want to start working on it. Now we want to try. So under is the play we're going to come out in. And we got four verticals. That's what you want to do next. You want to check your quick audibles. So as you see, PA fork. We have a post route as a quick audible. Okay. We have flanker spot, which is a corner route kind of thing. Post route to the tight end. We've got four verticals. And then we have the play we came out in. We have halfback zone weak as our audible down, which is a run that we can do a lot with. Very flexible run. You can run it inside or outside. Okay, so we can playmaker it to the right, and it's more of an interior run for sure. So that's interesting. Okay, so now what we want to do is kind of figure out how we're going to utilize all of this. So first things first, with your tight end, so we know this route to Ezekiel Elliott's good. We need to figure out how to get him the ball. One thing you can do is make a bench concept here to the left side. And then you can also, Zeke's going to come on his little route. You got to think about how are you going to get Jason Witten open on the deep post. What I would do is zig this tight end right here because it's going to hold that zone. Okay, so now once we're starting, we should know pretty clearly our first read is going to be this quick left side. If they press circle, that's going to mean a couple things. So if they press Dez Bryant, so we're in cover two. Let's go to Tampa two here, and I'm going to show you something. This just kind of comes from reps. They're going to press Dez. If they press Dez, you know immediately you're going there. Okay, let me show you what happens if they play underneath coverage though, because you're gonna need to kind of know this. So if they do that, then that's no longer open. As you can see, he's there. What's gonna happen is your key defender is gonna have to be that corner on the far left. If his first step is down, then that means you know, okay, I've got to wait, and then I'm gonna be able to hit Dez once he gets off the jam. Okay. So that's kind of how you know that. More than likely, though, you're going to be able to hit this quick out. So they're his first steps back. So I'm going to go the quick out, quick 5 yards. Okay. Now, say they do something a little bit different. So now you got to kind of get in their head. How would they start to combat this? Well, they might do something like this, where they go kind of like a Mabel, where they have a soft flat or a hard flat and a curl flat. So they have both covered. So we can't get there, but we do have the route to the running back now because everybody's coming out. So that's also important to realize. So now you're like, okay, so you see how it's starting to come together. So now I know, okay, well, if that linebacker goes out, then I know I can hit that. I can hit that route to the running back, which is Ezekiel Elliott there. Okay, so that's a big deal. The next thing that you want to do now is kind of start to play with it a little bit more and say, okay, so then what would I do to stop Ezekiel Elliott? Well, I would have to come down with this guy right here. Maybe make him in a hook type of curl. Okay, so now you're thinking, okay, that's not open, that's not open, that's not open. Tight end's wide open because of that route to that zig route. The reason we put him on a zig is for timing purposes only. If they not open, not open, not open, you can check down to the zig over here on this far side. It's very, very good against coverages that are largely, especially zone, which is what we're primarily facing. Zigs are very good. We'll show you this through man, but man coverage, you should be able to hit this quick out, should be wide open every time against man. It's an easy, easy read. Now, what you continue to go, you got to continue to kind of go with this. So then what I would do, so if they go man-to-man, now I'm starting to kind of really think through this. Now my triangle route, he's going to come right over the middle. Zeke's going to cut across the middle, which is good. The rest of the routes are not necessarily designed to beat man-to-man, especially like cross man and things like that. But you see, boom, 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 and you can just kind of keep checking. Okay, so this play is very effective. This is going to be what I would call our power play, at least our starting point, because it's very, very powerful with our quick reads. This is going to be a very, very powerful under center formation as well for our offense. Okay, so what are we going to do off of it? That's the big question, right? That's the question you have to ask yourself. PA fork, we know we have a post route in this. We have a built-in post route to square, so that's why we ran him short. Now we're going to run him in, okay? So now we haven't even dived into motion yet. We'll get into that in just a second. But what we're going to do with this is everything's the same. The only difference is square's route is a post, not a corner route. So we need to figure out, how do we get the post route open? I recommend smart routing it if you're in a situation where that's an effective strategy, i.e. first and 10, second and 9, things like that. And then what you want to do, what I would recommend doing actually, is taking your tight end, this X tight end who we ran him on a zig first, now we're going to run him on an in route. Okay? So we're going to run through. He's on an in route now, and we'll see if that gets open against cover two, and it does. It gets wide open. Okay, good. Now we want to kind of keep going. You've got to keep going with it. You've got to keep tinkering with it. Let's check it again. Now we make no smart route adjustments. Does it still get open? And as you see, it's wide open. Okay, that's good. Now what you want to do is you want to check. I mean, just keep going. Does it get open against cover three Mabel? So we audibled the defense to cover three Mabel. Is he open? Yeah, we can aggress. We could have cut that off. He was open. And we'll show you it right here. We'll do it again. Another thing that's important to figure out is, if I cancel the PA, does he still run his route? He does. Boom, wide open. Good. Now, what role? So this is where it kind of gets a little finicky in my opinion. What role does Des Bryant play on this play? Okay, because on the previous play, he ran a corner route, right? That's the corner route. Now, as you see, it's very similar. Okay, very, very similar route. So you want to kind of go through the gauntlet here. Tampa 2, if they call Tampa 2, You see, we can check down to Zeke. Zeke's being a hawk. If they go hard flat. Okay, so I call it Tampa 2 with a hard flat. Then Dez should be wide open as a possession catch. Beautiful. Now, in theory, if we keep going with this, if they call man-to-man, Dez Bryant should be wide open. If they just call a standard two-man under, Dez Bryant should be able to get wide open. And he does. He's able to get wide open. So that's beautiful. So all of the, they cross a check on everything. Now the question is, what about Jason Witten's route? What are we going to do with him? Because he's normally running a post route. Now he's running kind of a delayed curl. Let's look at this a little bit more closely as we get sacked here, which is not good. The cool part about Witten's route is he should stay in the block in situations where they might blitz us. So that's good. So he stays, and then he's going to come in a curl route, which is it's a very effective route. What his job is going to be is pass protection, and also he's going to be able to do a really good job at holding zones. Okay, let's try putting him on just a standard curl route, and as you can see, it holds the Tampa 2 really well. It holds those vertical hooks, which is a good deal. Let's see if we can get the same outcome with a smart routed out route. So get through that PA. That's probably a little bit better. This play would be perfect if Jason Witten was on a corner route, but he's not. Let's put him on a fade. Is there any reason to put, no, because he's gonna pull. Let's go a little further with that. Let's keep him on a fade route. Let's see what happens. So McClellan. How about something like this? Nice. Now the question that you gotta start kind of thinking about is, what about the user defender? Right? What's the user defender going to do? More than likely, the user defender is going to go and try and take away the post route. Okay? So in theory, they do something like this. Okay? So now the question is, who's open? Well, Zeke's open, but you're thinking this. If they use it right, this is a really solid. I think this is a really solid little play here. So he's wide open. So then, what would they do to? So what about cross man? Okay, so let's just kind of keep tinkering the things that they could do. So here we're gonna try this out. Let's see, we'll drop him here. Cross man. Something like this. And then he would man up on Witten. Something like this. Yeah, let's do this. And then we said to do this hot route. Okay. So we'll look. No, no. Post route beats man. Good. That's a big deal. It's a big deal for that route to beat man. Let's try it with someone like this. So what I'm trying to think, defensively, philosophy-wise, what they're going to do is they're going to say, okay, I've got to get someone on the inside of that post route. So what they're going to do is they're going to man up against that post route. And then you've got Bryant, they're going to leave the soft squat they think is going to take care of Bryant. They're not going to worry about Ezekiel Elliott necessarily. So then all they have to worry about is this route to Swam or the route to Witten. Okay, so let's see first and foremost if Swam's route. So they're going to user that. Yep, he stayed with him. Frustrating. I don't know how this, the defense, the pass protection on the play action is not. For some reason, play action blocking is just not very good for pass protection. It's good for blitz pickup. Okay, so let's go through this again. So I'm going to man him up here. I'm going to say that I'm just going to use her. I'm going to use her that. Okay. So in theory, can I make that catch? Yeah, that's kind of tender. He's probably got it at that point. So now what you want to do, once you've kind of figured out how they're probably going to stop you, and again, now this is really important. What will happen is, what will probably happen with this play is what happens with most plays, is they're going to cross man on the person they think is going to be breaking to the inside. Okay, so that, in this example, that's going to be Terrence Williams. Okay, what they're going to do then is they're going to try to make a user lurk on Swam and Witt because of timing purposes. What we need to do is something like this. Okay, so boom, boom, and then that's got to be a thing. Like, you got to be able to learn how to throw that ball. What you may need to do. And if they don't cross man, then you've got that wide open. So that's a good play. So that's another option. Now what we want to look at is our verticals play. Actually, let's look at flanker spot. Nothing there for me, in my opinion. Let's look at verticals. So first of all, let's test it against Tampa 2. He stays with him, okay. Let's see if we can't get this deep vertical. So it's got some promise. This play has some promise to it, I think. What we need to do is motion Williams into to the left a little bit. Get him out here. And then bring Swam on a drag. Witten on a drag. Swam on a streak. Dang it. Gosh, we've got to hold that safety somehow. Swam on a streak. Okay. Let's keep tinkering. See, that's wide open all day. So, I mean, they're going to have to do something. Another thing we could do off of this is something like this. Yeah, it's not really a good look. Not enough spacing. Let's try putting him on a streak. Brian on a straight streak. Nope, not there. So it looks like. Let's try putting Williams on a fade. And motion him out. Nope. See, that's what I'm saying, man. Under center pass protection is just hard for me to. If we motion Zeke to the left, this is an interesting motion here. So he comes out like this. It creates a little bunch. That's interesting. There's something there to that, I think. So we might experiment with that a little bit. We motion Zeke out. Creates a bunch package. He's wide open. Okay. One thing we could do also, this is cool, is if we motion Zeke out, put him on a slant, and we can get that delayed slant. Delayed. Boom. Nice. That'd be something. Yeah, I think there's definitely some play for this formation. So, HB zone weak. A lot of things you can do with this. This is definitely a powerful formation. For now, I'll leave you guys with this, and we'll move on to the next formation. But, let's go back and see if we can find something a little bit. Let me see if I can find one other play. What I'm really needing is this PA dig play is what we're needing. Because we have Chiefs under. Let's see, where's cover two sink at? Okay, so PA dig is kind of the hidden play that we're missing that will help us a lot. We've got under, which is good. PA power O will be a good. Actually, let's go PA. Let's look at PA power O. Okay, so we have a crossing route, which is really good. We'll probably motion him out. Okay. We're going to run bench concept with Witten. Yeah, that's what we'll run here. And then probably put the running back on just a block and release pattern. Witten will be wide open. Problem with the running back, man. The running back in the backfield, the only problem is if you motion him out. Let's see this. Bring him back in. Put him on a little swing route to the left, maybe. Let's see how that looks. That might be interesting. If we put him on a wheel, though, he goes to the right. See, that's the problem. He's on a check release. It's like, why would you even throw him the ball, though, on this swing route? Because if we throw it, he's in the backfield. I mean, it's going to take him a long time to get going. What if we put him on an out route? Yeah, that's not bad. Doesn't really do anything, I think, for the whole play itself. What we'll probably do at the running back, this will probably just be a four-man read. This play is really good, though. Because, like, I don't know. Yeah, he would just be on a block and release or a blocking. He's going right there. So, yeah, what I would do here, if you want to leave the play action on, you can. Because we will use the power O some. We'll just come out in it and run it. Because the power O is a really good little play. Let's see what it looks like if we don't motion Williams. It's about the same. You can get away with that. So you might just run it as is. Keep that auto motion on. The only problem, what I would do then in that case, is I would then definitely put him on a block and release, because he's going to release right into this little alley here, which is good. Yeah, your first read on, okay, so I kind of got it now. So let's do this. Let's run it as is. Our first read is R1 right there, just quick. You want to put your running back, I think you want to put him on an out route. Yep. We don't have anything to hold. Put him on a curl. Yeah, it doesn't really. It's not going to matter what you do with your running back. So you want to leave it. You really just kind of want to run this as is. That's your first read. Problem is, it doesn't really. If you made one change, I would put Witten on an out route because it makes the timing better. However, if you do that, if you put Witten on the out route, I would recommend putting Williams in motion, snapping him like that. That way they're coming across at the same time. One thing you might do even a little farther is to flatten Williams' route out and motioning him out and doing the delayed in route. Because that's going to be open a lot. And you might just say in and outs. Boom. Problem is he gets through too quick. See what I'm kind of thinking is timing. You want Williams to come at the right time, because if he comes too early, it doesn't work right. So what I would recommend doing is probably something like this right here, letting him set up in motion. And as you can see, there you go. So what they're going to think you're going to be running, if we do this right, they're probably going to think we're going to be running PA Fork. And so what we want to do is we want to make PA Fork look very similar to PA Power O. So the way that you're going to do that is you're going to run swam on a streak or a fade, and then you're going to motion the left side guy out. So then you're through, and they're going to think that that's where you're wanting to go. That's what they're going to think. What you're going to do though, which is interesting, is you're going to now. It's still going to be a play action, I guess. So that, like, still play action, boom, and then there it is. So that's going to be a good play, I think. The way they're going to stop that, and this is where it gets interesting, the way they're going to stop that is they're going to cross man. So they're going to cross man square. And the way that this is really going to work, we'll show you this kind of in a live gameplay at some point. They're going to actually start cross manning square. And what that's going to do, you want to let Williams set up. Do not snap it while he's in motion, otherwise he'll be delayed. But what that's going to do is he's now going to be out of the complete middle of the field. Actually, he swapped off there. That's interesting. He swapped off. That's interesting. Let me see this again. Maybe we did it wrong. So he's supposed to be guarding. They're going to say, don't throw it to Dez Bryant. We're going to say, okay, then take Terrence Williams. Let's see if this works. He's on him. Yeah, it's wide open. Boom. Beautiful. That'll work. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Yep, that'll work really good. If we put him on an in route, let's see this. One other thing I want to check. See, he's too early. They have time to recover. So, because you got to think about user and you got to have the right timing for that. So, that will work really well. What I would encourage you guys to do in this formation also is use halfback power O as a running play, because it's very effective. It's one of the better runs in the game. You get a kick out, boom, boom, and you've got a really good lane. Obviously, if they don't give you a good look for it, but like most of the time, you'll be able to get a really good kick out block, and you just run right down Broadway. And I'm telling you, this run is really good, especially like in the red zone. I'm actually thinking of running this more in the red zone because it's a really good run for like 2, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. It's a really, I'm telling you, this run. I'm excited about this formation now. I think I'm going to do a gameplay with this. This run is really good. Because here's why. Because they can't blow it up. Okay, most runs you can blow it up in the backfield, especially the zone runs. That's why I don't like zone runs, because they can really blow it up in the backfield. This run is very difficult to do that. Like, we're going to run into goal line here. Watch what happens. We're running right through it. And I mean, you've got those 2, 3 yards that you need. Okay, so this is one of those runs when the chips are down, run this play. I really, really wish it wasn't auto motion, but it is what it is. Like, if it wasn't auto motion, that would be perfect, because. But the auto motion does a good. I mean, it does a good thing for the play. But I'm telling you, this is a good run. It's not a home run hitting run. It's a run that's very subtle, going to take a lot of time. And again, you're not going to be able to motion guys, so there's a little bit of a tell there. But you can do some things. You can definitely do some things with this. One thing that you can do also, when you think about it, so for this run, they're used to seeing that tight end on the right go in motion. And we'll show you. I mean, you see the power of the run here. I mean, we're just running into the teeth of a defense. And I'm telling you, this run is really freaking good. I'm telling you guys. But I'll show you here. One thing you can do also. So if we wanted to run, the play we were running is PA. What's that play called? Where were we at? Single back ace, pair tight twins. One thing you can do, a passing play you can use off of it, is, let me find it. Where's cover two sync? I'm gonna show you this. See, this is where we're starting to get serious now. Okay. One thing that you can do off of this is you can run, if I find it. So here's PA Power O, which is a good, it'll work for what we want it to work for. It'll be fine. Another thing you can do though, I'm trying to think. Give me a second here. I'm trying to think. I'm trying to find a way. Yeah, here we go. Flanker spot. That's what you want. So it's a quick audible. It's a quick audible up. So when we run power O, Witten's the one that goes in motion. We're going to run this play now, and he's going to go in motion. We're just going to bring him all the way across. See that? He's going to come into this situation here. This is now a really good play because now we can do some things with this. This is interesting. It's just going to be ran basically like bench. I mean, there's nothing really complicated. You're going to put your running back on a block and release pattern. That's, you know, there's nothing else to really do with him. But it's a really good way to run bench. Because what will happen, you want to put your tight end, something like this. This is what you want it to look like right here. Okay? So now there, kind of thinking, what do I do now? Boom, boom, and that's in a really tender spot of the field. Okay, very tender. If you leave Williams on his route, and don't put him on a direct in route, what will happen is they'll fall away. So it's just something very little you can do. If you wanted to, you could put Witten on the out route and just run the corner, something like this. If you wanted to do that, you could. This is just another option because they're probably going to already expect Dez to be on a corner route. There, we're trying to throw it upfield for some reason. So yeah, if you wanted to go into four verticals, this is interesting. So if you want to go into four verticals, you bring Whitney across, just put him on a flat route. Now all of a sudden, you might be able to fit that in, kind of swerve him. So yeah, there's definitely a lot you can do from this little formation here. And the cool part is you can run. Like normally you're not able to run the ball in this year's game, in my opinion. But yeah. So there's definitely things you can do. What about in the goal line? What would I call in the goal line? Let me show you. We'll come up here. So in the goal line, show you what I would look for. So I want to stay in the same formation, so I kind of want to stay in this because this freaking formation is kind of fun. So a nickel normal, cover two sync, probably what they're going to call. Couple things. We know in our, we got it, first foremost, you got to know your quick audibles. I would just call under. I would call Chiefs under or whatever this under play. That's what I would call because of my quick audibles. Now, if I really wanted to change it up on somebody, I would call PA dig. But let's go over under real quick in the goal line. What you want to do, I actually used to call this religiously in the goal line. This formation is in the Steelers playbook as well. You want to smart route your corner route. You want to smart route your post route. Okay, then what you want to do is you want to take Swam here. You want to put him on a zig route. Why a zig route? It's the same kind of thing, I think. I think we put him on a zig route when we were talking earlier, too. So, yeah, nothing too fancy there. What you want to do then, if you want it to look the same as everything else, then I would recommend putting Terrence Williams on a quick out, and it would be literally exactly the same. Okay? If you don't care, and you're going for effectiveness, I would put him on a slant, motion into the right side of the field. Now, you could motion him to the left, but let me show you what happens. So if we do that, your first read is going to be triangle out of the backfield right there. And that's a quick throw, and it's going to work, I'm telling you. What's going to happen is they're going to start to user that play. See, now I'm getting excited because this is freaking fun. So what they're going to do is they're going to user triangle. So they're going to take him away with that. That's going to leave that right there in the back of the end zone wide open. Okay, it just is. What they'll do then from there is they'll start to cross man. So they're going to do something like this. So they have the hard flats, and then they're going to have purple here. Then they're going to take away triangle with this guy. They're going to take away this guy with cross man. They got a hard flat over here. They'll probably go purple over here. See how long this is going to take for them to adjust to it. Okay, and then they're going to leave this guy somewhere like this. This is what they're going to do. Okay, this is pretty much. And they're going to user over the middle. Now, what's going to happen is you're going to have, after they do all of that, you're going to be able, if you bring Williams in motion and kind of let him delay, look, nope, 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 yep, wide open in the back of the end zone. Williams. So, again, this is really, really, really effective. Let me show you real quick. Another thing that you want to do is halfback zone weak. When you're motioning it, you want to use the same motion. So what I would recommend is motion Williams in, let him get all the way out here, all the way, and go. And then you just fight. I mean, just fight through it. For some reason, it's not working very, very well. Zone weak is not the run. Power O is the run. Zone weak is a change-up run that you kind of are forced to use. I wish Power O was in there by default. What I want to show you now is PA dig. We'll show you that real quick. And we're already at 53 minutes. So PA dig, what you want to do is you want to smart route Dez Bryant's route. Okay, you want to smart route Jason Witten's route. You want to take Swam and put him on a quick out. And then you want to take Williams and you want to put him on a quick in route. Okay? From there, you're going to motion Williams in as if you were going to motion him on a slant route, but you're going to just snap it. So snap it, boom, set up and throw into the back of the end zone. You've got Dez Bryant. Okay? If you want to throw that. If you don't want to throw that, the beauty of this is that everything now works off one another. What I would do with Elliott, honestly, I would just block him. Okay, so you want to look at these quick patterns, Witten, X. Those are all quick patterns that you can look at. You know, kind of get in the lab with this. But I'm telling you what, this is a really good play. You can run the PA too if you want to. But in my opinion, you're gonna get sacked because just the way blocking works, man. I'm telling you. I think under center blocking is somewhat. The cool part about it is it's going to do better against like better players because better players are going to be used to trying to sack you in shotgun. Now all of a sudden you're an under center predominantly, so there's that you have going for you. Again, I would try hitting that route to Williams. You know, one thing also I'll share if you want to try this. I haven't tried this yet, but just smart route Williams' route, and then. Wait, we're in the wrong deal. So smart route, Williams route. Dez goes on an in route. Yeah, and then you're just going to motion him like this. And just kind of throw it high. That doesn't work. Doesn't look like that works very well. For verticals, here's another option for you. What you can do here is take Dez Bryant, put him on an out route. Okay, and then you can run Jason Witten on an in route. something like that. And you want to motion square out to the left. You want to high pass lead it when he cuts up to the back. You want to put him right in the back of the end zone there. That's a really, really good play. I would recommend trying that as well. I think that's one of the better plays, because what they're going to do, here's just so you know, this is what most people will do. They're going to play underneath coverage, and they're going to go hard flats. Okay. Off of that, what you're going to do, put something like this. Let's put Witten on a slant, not an in route. But yeah, and you're going to hit him right in the back of the end zone. So, again, that's something, guys. That's the ace pair chief. I think it's very effective. And again, I'm telling you, in the red zone, this power O run is money. I mean, it really is. You know, I mean, it's just good, man. Like, if you power it, if you get good blocking tight ends, I don't know, man. The Patriots just came to play, but they block shed like crazy. Practice mode, I think they block shed more than they do in the real game. But yeah, I'm telling you, you're not going to get stopped. That's the best part about this run is they can't stop you in the backfield. At least I haven't. I've yet to been stopped in the backfield. You're going to find about 4 or 5 yards every time you run this, no matter what defense they run. I mean, you're just going to be able to just walk through it for at least 2 to 3, which is all you really want. I mean, when you're in the goal line, you know, 2 to 3 yards is money. You want to just follow your guard right off tackle there. And when you kind of read, if your guard kicks out, then that's good. If he doesn't, it's like right here, you're going to follow up. Boom. And it's just a quick little run. For some reason, practice mode, they are block shedding like freaking crazy. But yeah, you just want to follow your blocks, man. I'm telling you, this run will get you a touchdown. I mean, it's a very good run for red zone because it gets you 2 to 3 yards in a cloud of dust every freaking time. I mean, it's just so effective. And then real quick, you can run PA off of it. And the cool part about that is you smart route Swam. You can't smart route Dez, unfortunately. But what will happen is you can high point Williams. Something like that. And what you can do with Dez is just put him on a slant. So your first read, flat. Second read, slant to Dez. And that works the same as a post. What I would probably recommend is maybe put him on a curl. Because it's just, you know, on top of everything else that you're doing. You know, and then yeah, it's definitely something to try out. I think this formation's definitely got some play to it. Let's break down real quick. Let's talk very briefly about the five wide from the bunch. You wanna come out in. You have deep curl. Let's see. I'll show you this real quick. It's the same concept. It's the same concept. That's the thing. You do the same thing. You just do it for multiple formations. The reason I like the ace pair chief better than the five wide probably is just because you have option to run the ball, better pass protection, that kind of stuff. But the five wide is good too. So we'll look at that real quick. So your quick audibles, you have Z spot. You have drive corner, which is really, really good. You have post corner read, which is really good. And then you want to come out in this drag curl. Okay? So circle is your Z spot post. What we're going to do here, just so you know, if we're dropping a lot of guys back in coverage, this is a really good run, especially if you have a mobile quarterback. So what we want to establish is this post corner read, because it's a C route. Okay, so what you're going to do is very simple. We're going to take Jason, we're going to put him on an out route, and we're going to motion the C route to the outside. Okay, from there we're going to take Ezekiel Elliott, we're going to put him on an in route. Okay, and then we'll take Dez. You can leave him on the C route if you want to. I would recommend putting him on a quick out or a quick fade, which either or will work. I like probably for the flow of this play, probably he'll be on a fade. Okay? Your first read is Jason Witten, quick. Normally that's going to be wide open. Your second read, let's see, we're going to do drive corner right. Or no, we're doing, what are we doing? Post corner read. Yeah. Your second read is going to be Ezekiel Elliott. So you're going to look right, nope, left, yes. Okay? Just like that. What you could do, I'm trying to think of how this would work, but you could do it if you wanted. Post corner read. No, let's not do it. I don't think it works really well, actually. Changed my mind. So same exact thing. Your third read is going to be circle on the C route. So nope, nope, circle. And you can do the math there. If you smart route it, it makes it go a little bit shorter, I think. And that's probably the best for this if you're in like a first and 10 situation. But something like this, boom, boom, no, no, no. And then you've got your, as you can see, I mean, the thing about this is the C route will probably not be open if they're running cover two, okay? The deep post to Cole Beasley will be open if they're running that. If they're also, but if they're running cover two man, you've got that C route. Very good route for cover two man. So that's that. And it's very similar to PA post. Let's go drive wide corners. This is a really good play. We've got two big time corner routes. What you want to do is you want, or actually, let's go back. Let's go post corner read. So that's that play. I'm trying to think if I can share anything else. If I need to share anything else with you. When you motion Williams out, actually, let's do this. Let's snap him like that. That's the timing a little bit better. We can get the ball there. Why? Actually, let's go over this one more. Let's try one other thing, one other option. Let's put Dez on an in route. Let's put Zeke on a slant. Let's put Witten like that, and let's motion Zeke out, delayed slant. So boom, boom. Yeah, that'll work. The thing is, guys, they're going to eventually come down on your shorter routes, and you're going to hit that deep post route. Let's go over drag curl. So this is the opposite, right? Basically, what we're going to do here is we're going to put Witten on an out route, okay? Then we're going to take... see if we do it like this. Yeah, that'll work just fine. The only problem is I don't want Zeke on that route. Let's keep him in tight. Zeke on a slant. Dez on an in route. We're going to motion Zeke, delay slant. Yep. And that's open. Yeah, that'll work. What I would actually also recommend is putting Beasley on a fade. There we go. That's going to work good. So out, boom. Witten, again, your first read. As you can see, that deep post route. Okay. So there's that. And then one other play. Drive corner. Well, what's Z-spot got? Z-spot we would just run bench with. And we would just motion Witten into the slant. So that's just bench. Very simple. But I'm telling you, the power of the quick outs and the quick slants will open up those deeper routes. Drive wide corner is a very important play. What we're going to do is we're going to put Cole Beasley on an out route. we're going to put Terrence Williams on an in route. And we're just going to motion Terrence Williams out like so. And then this route to Witten is going to be pretty good. I'll show you this one more time here. You could put Williams on a delayed slant if you wanted. We're going to fall away. Why is that not working right? Drive corner should open up. Actually, let's do maybe something like this. Let's check this left side out. There he is. You can fit that in. What you could do off of this is take Williams, put him on a deep streak, take Beasley, put him on a zig route. Zeke's gonna go on a deep in, and then take Dez, and you can leave Dez on that route. That'll work actually probably a little bit better, because you'll be able to get a worst comparison. You would actually, what you probably want to do is motion Dez. Or you can't motion Dez. You would want to motion Witten to the left side, and then we would just run Cole Beasley on a streak, and Terrence Williams on an in route, and that would be what you would run. And you'll see here that route to Dez is going to be either wide open or the out route's going to be open. So you need to take your out routes is what I'm trying to say. And then Z spot smash, take that route. So that's the five wide. It's very simple, but I'm telling you, it's very effective. The one problem, if we motion Zeke to the right, here's an interesting thing. He comes into the backfield. Okay. You can start putting, and then you can put him on a wheel route and bring him back out. And now he's going to run a wheel route. So that's something that you can, you know, I mean, there's definitely room for that. There's definitely some creative options, and you can mess with that and do what, you know, what you're going to do. If you motion him to the left, as you see, he's just going to go out. But yeah, again, there's so much more to it than just what I'm saying here, and I'll show you in the game, but those are the setups. If you wanted to run, I'm trying to think of how to share this with you. You go Z spot, Cole's going. What if we go post corner read and then drag curl? So you would only be able to do it from drive corner. If you do this from drive corner, I'm telling you, if you take Zeke, yeah, I mean, if you just do this, you'll see Cole Beasley. There's your out route wide open. And eventually, because this formation's a little spread, a little bit more spread out, it means a cut. It means something. So, zoom in like this, and see it's gonna leave the underneath wide open. I mean, that's the bottom line. And then you can use you can smart route Terrence Williams post route to make it go a little shorter here. And then you can, man, there's so much you can do with this formation. Motion him in. Yeah. So I mean, I would say the most important thing though is to take your ins and outs route, and your in routes and your out routes are really, really important. Let's see this. Show you this here real quick. So there's, see how the post route gets open. And then drive corner, or no, post corner read is a big time play too, because you have that post route. If you leave Dez on the C route, it actually probably won't be that big of a deal. You could probably get away with it. Yeah. So this package is money, but what you've got to learn with this package specifically, and I'll probably do a gameplay with both packages for you. You've got to learn to take your short reads, because if you don't, you know, it's, you know, these routes take a long time to develop. So if they're rushing four every time, you're gonna be in trouble. But anyways, guys, that's a little bit of an example of what I'm gonna do. I only broke down two formations, but I think I broke down two of the really money formations from this. So that's kind of what I do when I look at a new playbook. So hopefully this was helpful. If you have questions, please ask. If you liked this, please subscribe to the channel. Okay, so those are some things that I would say. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments about anything. It doesn't have to be just related to this video, anything in Madden.